Hello everyone, I'm Ihsan. In this video, we'll be looking at the 14 newest features in the latest version of WhatsApp application. Okay, let's now take a look at what these newest features are. The first feature is a simple feature but quite useful for everyday use of WhatsApp, which is the swiping tab feature that was previously available. This feature was previously available before the layout of WhatsApp moved to the bottom. In the previous beta version, when the options in the WhatsApp application were moved to the bottom, the swiping tab feature was missing and couldn't be used. But now, finally, with the latest beta update, the swiping tab feature has been reintroduced. Then, the second new feature is the privacy checkup feature. You can find this privacy checkup feature in the latest WhatsApp settings. And then you can navigate to the privacy section where you'll find the privacy checkup feature right away. The purpose of the privacy checkup feature is to assess the privacy settings of the WhatsApp application on your smartphones. It allows you to quickly identify which WhatsApp application settings are associated with privacy concerns. It enables you to make immediate adjustment according to your preferences. Here, all the settings related to privacy on WhatsApp are put together in this one privacy checkup option. Next, we have the third feature, which is the edit messages feature. This feature has actually been available in several previous beta versions. And the function of this feature is basically to edit the message you have just sent. However, please note that you can only modify messages that are not older than 15 minutes. Once the 15-minute mark has passed, you won't be able to edit the message anymore. Moving on, the next new feature is the profile pictures display, which is now readily available on the WhatsApp group view. This feature has also been included in several previous beta versions. And for the latest display of the WhatsApp group, now it will immediately display the profile photos of the members who type messages in the group. Then the next new display is the number that is displayed when you select multiple photos at once when you want to send multiple photos inside the WhatsApp application. In this new display, you can immediately see the number of all the photos you selected. So you can find out how many photos you have already selected when sending the photos inside the WhatsApp application. Then in the latest version of WhatsApp, you now have the ability to directly chat WhatsApp support within the application itself. To access this new option, you can go to the settings and select help option. And here you will find a new feature that allows you to directly contact WhatsApp support without having to leave the application. To access this latest option, you can navigate to the Help Center menu. Then inside the Help Center menu, you can press the support button. Then you can directly tap on the Contact WhatsApp support section. And then you can state your issues while using the WhatsApp application, and it will be sent directly to the WhatsApp support team. Then another exciting feature is the screen sharing feature. This feature allows you to share your smartphone screen display during a video call. It can be incredibly helpful when you need to explain certain tips or settings, which are easier to understand by directly showing your smartphone screen. Next, there's also a new feature that allows WhatsApp story updates of almost 2 minutes in length, or to be more precise, up to 1 minute and 47 seconds. We have previously tested this feature in one of the accounts in the previous beta version, and we confirmed that it could indeed reach 1 minute and 47 seconds. However, in the latest version of WhatsApp that we use in this video, it appears that the option to have WhatsApp stories of nearly 2 minutes is no longer available. So maybe there is a possibility that this feature has been removed, or maybe it can also be added in the next WhatsApp update. Then the latest visual changes in the beta version of the WhatsApp application are also immediately visible when you open some of the settings. For the new display of the settings inside the WhatsApp application, the new buttons now have adopted the Material UI. In addition to that, the latest version of WhatsApp also introduced a new visual feature called floating buttons. These buttons dynamically adjust and change their appearance based on the tab or section you select. Then for the settings in the latest version of the WhatsApp application, now you can directly modify the port for the proxy settings. The WhatsApp proxy is a feature that allows you to connect the WhatsApp service via a proxy server. The server acts as a mediator between the user and the WhatsApp server. And this can help you access WhatsApp in specific regions where the service might be blocked or experiencing network issues. And then the next exciting feature is the ability to directly send photos in higher quality. And finally, now in this latest beta version, when you send a photo, at the top you can see the HD button. By tapping on it, you can select the desired quality for the photo you want to send. You can choose standard quality or HD quality. If you want to send photos with the highest quality without sending them as files, you can select HD quality. Then the next exciting feature is the ability to send short video messages in WhatsApp chats. The feature is very similar like sending voice messages. To send a video message in this latest version is very easy. All you need to do is tap on the microphone icon, which will then change the microphone icon to video icon. And then to send a short video message, you can simply press and hold the video icon just like when sending a voice message. The options for recording a video message are the same as when recording a voice message. To lock the recording, you can swipe up, and to cancel, you can swipe to the left. While recording a video, you can also switch between the front and rear cameras by tapping the icon on the left. Then the latest feature introduced in the iOS version of the WhatsApp application is the link device feature. It allows you to link the same WhatsApp account to two different smartphones. And finally, now with the recent update of the WhatsApp application on iOS or iPhone, you can now use your iPhone as a secondary device for WhatsApp using this new link device feature. For more detailed tips on how to set it up on your smartphone, you can directly check the previous video, which you can tap on the video that appears on your screen. Hopefully useful. See you in the next video.